Hi guys, welcome to this video brought to you by Tapflo UK. Today's video is going to be all about mag drive pumps. Now today we're going to cover how they work, where they're used, the main advantages and the main disadvantages of a mag drive pump. Strap yourself in and we'll get going. Now in this segment of the video, we're going to go over the quite interesting concept of how a mag drive actually works. Now to start off with, the main point on this is the actual fluid that goes into the pump and the impeller itself are maintained within a hermetically sealed chamber. Now what that means, in layman's terms, is it's airtight, which drastically minimises the risk of fluid and vapour leakage from the pump itself. The drive shaft from the motor is connected to an outside layer of magnets. These are outside of the actual chamber itself. These are known as the drive magnets. Within the pump, there is the driven magnets, also known as the inside magnets. These are opposing to the outside magnets. When the motor spins the outside magnets, the drive magnets, the internal magnets also spin. Now this is where it gets quite clever. Those inside magnets that are opposing to the outside magnets are connected to the impeller. So when this outside layer spins, the inside layer spins with it, therefore creating the suction into the pump and discharge out. In this part of the video, we're going to go over the main advantages and disadvantages of a mag drive pump. Now the main advantages and the main one does resort back to the first two sections, where we previously mentioned about it being a sealless design, therefore minimising the risk of leaked fluid and vapour. It's perfect for that, as we previously mentioned. Now the second benefit is that it's actually made up of very few parts. That means if you select the right manufacturer, you look after the pump, you're going to ensure long life with pretty low amount of maintenance. Now the third benefit does go back to the maintenance side. Because of the simple coupling design, you're not going to need any alignment of the motor and the pump itself. It's perfect for that also. The pump's available in many different materials. This one's here PP. You can also get it in PVDF. You can get them ETFE lined. You can get them in stainless steel. You can get it in the right material to suit your application. Now there are a couple of downsides to a mag drive pump. The first being that they're best suited to clean fluids. Okay, so if you're pumping anything that could have dirt or small amount of solids in it, no matter how small they are, we wouldn't recommend a mag drive pump. And the second being that they do use quite a lot of power compared to a conventional centrifugal pump. We're not saying that that's a bad thing, but it is something you should consider. So you want to see a good example of a mag drive pump? Well, lucky enough for you, I've got one in front of me. Now this here is from the Tapflo CTM range. This right here is the 40 series of that range. Okay, so it's got a 2.2 kilowatt motor. It's got a polypropylene head. You're going to get about 16.5 meters cubed an hour max flow out of the pump with a max head of about 18 meters. This one here is going to a chemical factory where they're pumping a chemical and it's just a simple transfer duty. If you've got any requirements for pumping chemicals or you think you need a mag drive, let us know. And if you've got any questions, leave them in the comments. We'll be happy to answer them. Cheers. Thanks for watching.